Now, after the discoveries in Godavari, Pravara and Bhima Basin, and particularly the Krishna Basin site of Yedurwadi, now we will be talking about the sites in the upper Krishna Basin, that is in the Satara region, the new discoveries within last 7 to 8 years. Now in the upper Krishna Basin, that is in the Satara region, I could discover a number of localities where Acheulean artifacts are found in different geomorphic contexts. Now you can see in this photo, there is one context that is channel gravel, coarse channel gravel. Now it was earlier suggested that these channel gravels are particularly young, that is of the late Pleistocene age, about 1 lakh years old. But with the discovery of these Acheulean artifacts from this gravel, now we can say this gravel is a mixture of older gravel, that is middle Pleistocene or early Pleistocene gravel, combined with this late Pleistocene gravel. So on the basis of discovery of artifacts and their geomorphic context, it can be suggested that this gravel is a composition or mixture of these older and younger gravels. You can see these Acheulean artifacts lying within these gravel bars of these rivers, particularly the Urmodi River. Now you can see in this photograph, there are Acheulean artifacts in situ found from this Brashey conglomerate, or a conglomerate which is on the left bank of Urmodi River. Now this conglomerate is a mixture of angular pieces along with rounded stones which were brought by the river. So it is a mixture of colloidal and alluvial deposit from which Acheulean artifacts, that is angular artifacts, flakes and cores and some cleavers were collected. Now this another context is this cobbly rubble horizon, that is the weathered bedrock surface above which Acheulean occupation was going on, and Acheulean artifacts could be collected from this cobbly rubble surface. Now another context is this older weathered gravel, that is which is called as high level gravel, on the banks of Koyna River at the site of Nisre. Now this a few Acheulean artifacts were also collected from this high level gravel. Now there is one important site at Menavli. Now this Menavli is very famous as a tourist attraction spot with a temple and a ghat. Now at this site also I could discover a few Acheulean artifacts, particularly from this left bank conglomerate and also from the present day channel. Basically this older conglomerate is being eroded by the present day Krishna River, and these Acheulean artifacts are found from this present day channel. Now you can see these artifacts lying in the present day river of Krishna. Now these kinds of models are being made while studying these Acheulean sites. Now on the left bank you can see this conglomerate capping the bedrock from which Acheulean artifacts were collected. Interestingly, this conglomerate does not have laterite component. So basically this Krishna River coming from Mahabaleshwar has laterite capping. But when we find that in this lower conglomerate, older conglomerate, there is no lateritic cobbles or pebbles. So certainly this is a older river or a river coming from north of Krishna, that is Kamandal River. So it is a mixture of Krishna and Kamandal, and Acheulean activity was going on during particularly this middle Pleistocene age. So you can find Acheulean artifacts from this older conglomerate and now the present day channel also. So now during this explorations, one innovative method was devised, was introduced. Particularly when Acheulean artifacts were collected from the river channel, it is very difficult to identify these artifacts and distinguish them from the natural pieces from the river. So when we collect some flakes from the Acheulean flakes from the channel, we have to be careful while we collect it. We keep it for drying, and while they are drying, we can find there are ripple marks or radiating type of marks. You can see in this image that these kinds of marks can be seen, and on that basis we can see the point of percussion or bulb of percussion from which the Acheulean artifacts or the large flakes can be distinguished from the natural pieces. So now how these large flakes were removed? So these kinds of giant cores, or there will be boulders or cobbles of more than 15 or 20 or 25 centimeters. So these kinds of boulders and slabs were found, and from which large flakes were removed. Now you can see these examples of some cleavers and cleaver flakes from this upper Krishna Basin, particularly the site of Menavli and the sites in the Urmodi River Basin. Now these another examples of some cleaver flakes. Now coming into the Konkan region. Now Konkan region has some different kind of lower paleolithic activity, particularly the lower southern Konkan. We have a site at Hadi on the river Gad. You can see a photograph of an excavation carried out by Dr. Statira Gazdar in 1960s and 70s. At this site she discovered large flakes. Now these large flakes are certainly claimed as lower paleolithic, but Acheulean element, that is cleavers and hand axes, these are lacking from this evidence. So it is a lower paleolithic assemblage without Acheulean. Now there is another important Acheulean site in the district of Ratnagiri near Guhagar. There is a lateritic cave. This site was discovered by Dr. A.R. Marathe, from which some artifacts of Acheulean were found or made on rhyolitic rock. Now this rhyolitic rock is not available in the surroundings, so it is still to be seen from where this rock came. Now this is an important site. It is the only cave site on the Konkan coast where Acheulean artifacts were found. Now after this Acheulean sites, particularly there are sites in Vidarbha region as well, but there have been not been studied properly. So now we come into the Middle Paleolithic. Now what is the difference between Acheulean, or that is Lower Paleolithic, and Middle Paleolithic? Now particularly in the Middle Paleolithic, we have introduction of new technology, that is Levallois technology or prepared core technique, where flakes are removed from the sides of the core and then a central flake, that is a triangular or pointed flake, is being removed. So these kinds of innovation can be seen in Middle Paleolithic. Now in Middle Paleolithic in India, as far as concerned, it goes beyond 3 lakh years ago. But in Maharashtra, we don't have a date as such for Middle Paleolithic, but certainly we can say that it is of late Middle Pleistocene and early late Pleistocene. So now what is in Middle Paleolithic? That is, artifact size is reduced. From Acheulean we have large flakes, that is flakes of more than 10 centimeters. But in Middle Paleolithic we have medium sized flakes, that is about 5 to 8 centimeter sized flake, and tools made on that, and sometimes even smaller flakes. Now different types of tools were devised in this Middle Paleolithic. The tools include points, scrapers, borers, and sometimes burins as well. Now raw material also changed during Middle Paleolithic phase. Now raw material preferred was siliceous material or fine grained material. Now some of the important sites of Middle Paleolithic are like Nevasa, which is from where Middle Paleolithic was known, and then there are some sites in Vidarbha region, some in Marathwada region. So these kinds of Middle Paleolithic sites are there in Maharashtra particularly, but limited work has been carried out on the Middle Paleolithic phase, particularly in Maharashtra. Now Middle Paleolithic sites are found nearby the rivers and as well as away from the rivers. Particularly the Acheulean sites we have seen mostly are in the near the river banks. Now these are some of the photographs of Middle Paleolithic tools collected from various parts of Maharashtra. Now this particular image is from Wadoli Wagodi on the Godavari near Paithan. Now these are some Middle Paleolithic or early Middle Paleolithic tools from Vidarbha region near Nagardhan. And then there is Middle Paleolithic has been also divided in different phases. Now this you can see in the photo that there is transition from late Middle Paleolithic to late Paleolithic. So you can see on the right side corner there are smaller blade like elements coming up, that is laminar elements coming up in the late Middle Paleolithic going into the late Paleolithic. Now finally we come to the upper Paleolithic or late Paleolithic. Now this upper Paleolithic is basically within last 40 or 45,000 years. Particularly in Maharashtra we have a particular date at Patne of about 25,000 years ago. So at this upper Paleolithic, what are the typical features are that blade and burin industry, that is small tools of about 3 to 4 centimeters. You can see the photos on the right side. Then there are sometimes we find bone implements as well, but in Maharashtra we did not find any bone tools as such as far as now. Then there are new hunting strategies has been certainly found, that these smaller tools were certainly used as composite tools. So these kinds of stone tools cannot be used directly by hand. Now on this new hominin ancestors, particularly the modern man or Homo sapiens, is certainly within last 45 or 50,000 years we have this modern man. And then we can see behavioral modernity and art during this upper Paleolithic phase or late Paleolithic phase. Now one important site is of Patne in Maharashtra. You can see one photograph from the excavations at Patne on the left, and important discovery of ostrich eggshells and beads or engraved ostrich eggshells on the right side. Now this ostrich is finding of ostrich eggshells is very important because it shows arid phase in Maharashtra region, and it shows that ostrich was there in Maharashtra around 25 to 30,000 years ago in Maharashtra's arid landscape, that is in northern Maharashtra in Jalgaon or Dhule area. Now you can see the photographs from the sites or the drawings of blades and burin tools from the site of Patne, where you can see the small size and various different types of raw materials used like jasper, chalcedony being used. Now you can see these blades and burins are particularly dominating. Then various types of geometric and non-geometric tools are also found from the site of Patne. Now the site of Patne, again the distribution is divided from late Middle Paleolithic to upper Paleolithic. Within upper Paleolithic there have been divisions. So you can see on the left to right you can see some differentiation within the tools. Now to summarize, Maharashtra has a rich Paleolithic record, particularly from the Acheulean times. Now in Acheulean we have large flake based tools. Now, stone tools are remarkably in abundant quantities. Apart from stone tools, there are some fossils and then ostrich eggshells in the later prehistoric period. Now, these sites have been distributed or have different geomorphic contexts, particularly the fluvial context, that is river-based sites, colluvial sites, that is hill slopes or pediment surface or regolithic surface sites. Then there are sites near the coast of Konkan coast. Then there are some cave sites or rock shelter sites. These are in limited numbers. Now, humans have adapted to different time periods, running into different paleo-environmental situations. Like this, early Pleistocene certainly had a humid phase, followed by middle Pleistocene, which had a semi-arid phase. And in late Pleistocene, we had more aridity setting in. So basically, humans have adapted to semi-arid, arid, and even humid climates, particularly in the high rainfall zones, like in the upper Krishna basin. Now, we can see from this presentation that humans even faced the catastrophic tephra fall event, which has been dated to different time periods, letting apart the time period controversy. But tephra fall certainly was experienced by the humans. Now, different kinds of raw materials were used or exploited during different Paleolithic phases. Particularly in the Acheulean phase, we have basalt or dolerite dike being exploited particularly. A few limited siliceous material stone tools were also found from this lower Paleolithic phase. Now in Vidarbha and Konkan region, quartzite has also been used. When we come to the middle Paleolithic phase, we have siliceous raw materials such as jasper, chert, chalcedony, and other siliceous materials being exploited for making smaller size stone tools. Now chronologically, the Acheulean culture is certainly of the late early Pleistocene, that is about 8 to 10 lakh years ago. It started in Maharashtra, particularly as far as present day studies are concerned, and continued into the middle Pleistocene phase. Now during this middle Pleistocene phase, the Acheulean activities were widespread in Maharashtra region. Now middle Paleolithic, there is limited work has been carried out, but middle Paleolithic we have certainly sites coming from the early late Pleistocene, that is about 1 lakh years ago, and continued into the late Pleistocene about 25-30,000 years ago. Now when we talk about late Paleolithic or upper Paleolithic in Maharashtra, we have Paleolithic, upper Paleolithic sites dated to about 25-30,000 and continued till about 12,000 or 13,000 before present, that is BP. So now this is the chronology of Paleolithic sites in Maharashtra. Now through these episodes, we can understand that Maharashtra has a rich prehistoric past. Now these prehistoric studies have been carried out over last 7 to 8 decades by various scholars, particularly from the Deccan College. Now Professor Sankalia took the lead and it was followed by his students and their students. So particularly this young generation like me should continue these prehistoric studies and the study of Paleolithic cultures in Maharashtra, focusing on the Acheulean culture, particularly in the Western Maharashtra and other upland areas, then Middle Paleolithic culture, wherever it can be studied, and Upper Paleolithic sites or the Late Paleolithic Microlithic sites. So there are various issues and challenges to be still addressed in Maharashtra's prehistory, and prehistory studies can be useful for future generations as well. Thank you.